Now, Madeline, I want you to use We're about to start. So let's get ready.
Yes, ready.
Excellent. Okay, so I think we're going to start with the people we have. We have Pedrina, Ricardo, Jennifer, and Claudia. Hello. How are you today? Good? So-so? Más o menos,
So-so, okay.
Cansado. Cansado is tired. I feel tired. But it's Wednesday. Apenas miércoles, ya está cansado. This one, I think Monday is the most difficult day of the week. Para mí el lunes es el más difícil. ¿No sientes que el lunes es más cansado?
No.
For me, Monday is the worst.
Este día es más cansado.
Really? Yeah, for me, it's Monday and Friday. They are terrible. And Saturday is so easy. Pero Wednesday yo lo siento normal.
Friday is a good day.
It's a good day. No, I have a lot of meetings on Friday.
Tengo para demasiado.
¿Ah? Tengo demasiado
para
meetings.
Mí every day.
Every day. Every day, forever, no, forever.
Yes.
Every day is difficult. But let's drink water, let's drink coffee, let's drink everything so we can wake up. Now, we're going to have here today, let's start with our class number 18. Let's start here with class number 18. We have unit 4, right, for the National English for Work program in support. We're going to have 4 different competences, and we're going to practice prepositions of place practice. Right? We already did that. Ya lo hicimos, así que no nos preocupemos. Right? We already did that. But we're going to practice here with countable and uncountable nouns. Right? Now, yesterday I was telling you that there are countable and uncountable nouns. Right? This was a topic that we wanted to see because of the use of there is and there are. So right now we're going to see a little bit of grammar. I need you to please pay attention to the class, right? So we can understand a little bit of countable and uncountable nouns. So we have countable nouns. Countable nouns have a singular and plural form. For example, a tree. 2 trees, right? And they can also use singular verbs or a plural verb. The book is all, the books are all, okay? So, countable nouns are going to help us for there is and there are, right? Both are going to help us in the same manner, in the same manner. So we can say there are 2 supervisors in my company, okay? There are 5 teachers in Inglés Corporativo. There is only 1 boss, right? When we use there is and there are. Now, tenemos nombres contables o sustantivos contables ¿Qué son los sustantivos contables? Son aquellos que se pueden contar. Esa es la explicación más básica. We can count them. We can count countable nouns. Si usted no los puede contar, no son contables. Okay? That's the first thing. For example, a tree, two trees. A computer, two computers. A tablet, two tablets. Right? Also, singular nouns, right? They can use singular verbs or a plural verb. The book is all, the books are all. Solamente cambia acá, mire, tree, trees, book, books, right? Do we understand this? ¿Entendemos esta parte? ¿Entendemos? ¿No? ¿Jamás?
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Ok, después ya lo voy a preguntar. Así que si me dicen yes, es porque yes. Uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns, they cannot be counted. Ok, we cannot count countable nouns. Ok, and look at the examples that they are giving us. Right? In uncountable nouns, we only have one form. We cannot say butter. Right. Butter is butter all the time. Mantequilla is butter. Y así se queda. Mantequilla es mantequilla. Right? We cannot say one butter, two butters, three butters. Okay? It's going to stay the same way like forever. And they always use a singular verb. Okay? Uncountable nouns always use a singular verb. Okay? So there is sugar in my house. There is butter in my fridge. There is rice in my kitchen. Okay? Siempre vamos a utilizar is o una forma plural, una forma singular del verbo. Okay? No plural. Siempre que tenemos un sustantivo no contable, vamos a utilizar la forma singular del verbo, ¿ok? En cualquiera de su conjugación, siempre será la forma singular, no la forma plural. That means that with uncountable nouns, we cannot use a, an, or a number before them. We cannot say a sugar, a butter. Mm-mm. That's a big no-no. That's a big no-no, right? So we need to make sure that we did not use them, okay? Do we understand this part? ¿Se entiende esta parte?
No.
No. Okay, questions. ¿En qué parte se quedó? ¿O empezamos?
Si no podemos contar, por ejemplo, rice, entiendo, pero bread... porque no podemos contar un pan. Si yo quiero decir pásame dos panes, ¿cómo tengo que decir?
Good question. That's a perfect question. Thank you so much. When we say pásame dos panes, that doesn't exist in English. We're going to say give me a piece of rosado. No. Let me put a piece of bread. A piece of bread. So we have quantifiers. Okay. These are quantifiers. Estos en los nombres no contables, ellos solos no se pueden contar. Okay. Entonces necesitamos palabras antes de ellos que nos digan, ah, esto es lo que quiero. Okay. Entonces, ¿cuánto quiero? Un pedazo de pan. A piece of bread. Okay, a piece of bread or some bread. Oh, I'm going to eat some bread. Algo de pan, right? Un pedacito de pan, right? A loaf of bread. Right? Cuando le dan así como un, ¿cómo se llama? Un baguette. A loaf of bread, right? So that's what we call a quantifier. Right? That's what we call a quantifier in English. For example, when we say rice, a pound, oh, sorry, a pound of rice. A pound means this, a pound, una libra. ¿Sabían? Ese símbolo es lo mismo en inglés y en español. Libra, en inglés, pound, es el mismo símbolo, LB, ¿ok? So a pound is going to be the same, right? Then, that's a good question, right? For example, butter, right? A piece of butter, a pinch of sugar, a pinch of, una pizca de azúcar, right? A pinch of, that's what we're going to use. A pinch, pinch of. A pinch of sugar, a pinch of salt in the food, right? So that's what we use for uncountable nouns when we want to count them, right? Yesterday, I think one of you told me, I think Francis told me that we have to say a lot of money, right? A lot of money. We have money is uncountable, right? We cannot say one money, two monies, three monies. No, we're going to say a lot of money, right? Some money, a few money, or no money, no money at all, okay? That's the like the basics for uncountable nouns. I have another example, okay? Is this part clear, Ricardo? ¿Se entiende?
Sí, sí, entiendo.
Sí, okay. Vamos a ver muchos quantifiers en lo que queda de tiempo, así que no se preocupe, okay? For example, we have milk, right? You know milk, leche, right? Milk is an uncountable noun. No podemos contar la leche, milk. So we say, I need a glass of milk. Ahí sí ya podemos contarlo. ¿Cuánto de leche? A glass of. Or we can say a gallon of milk. Right? A liter of milk. Un litro de leche, un galón, un vaso, right? Okay, that's when we count them. Very good question, Ricardo. Now, anybody else? Do you have a question about uncountable nouns? Pregunten, por favor. Hello.
Teacher.
Yes.
Solo quiero ver si entendí la última parte, la parte de abajo donde dice de que para los nouns que no son contables, no se va a usar la AN y tampoco los números.
Exactly. That is correct, Nelson. No podemos decir...
Esas serían las excepciones para no utilizar esas como complemento.
Exacto. Por ejemplo, en este caso... Nunca, nunca, cuando tenga un sustantivo no contable, nunca vaya a utilizar a, an, o cualquier número. Por ejemplo, como le de ejemplo aquí, two rice, two bread, no. Acá en El Salvador sí decimos dos panes, dame dos panes, right? But in English we can't. En inglés no es posible decir eso. Porque vamos a decir a piece of, a piece of. ¿Qué?
O sea que en inglés... Lo que uno solo menciona es, primero, el, así en plural, lo que quiere. Luego, si le dice, ah, ¿cuántos quiere? Y si solo le dice, ah, dos o tres, ahí sí puede. ¿O no? Por ejemplo, si yo dijera, quiero pan, y entonces, ah, ¿cuántos quieres? O está bien solo uno o algo así. Yo, ah, no, deme tres o deme cuatro.
No puede ser números.
No puede.
No puede, porque este no es plural. Los números no contables no son plurales. Entonces usted le va a decir, I want some bread.
Ajá, sí.
Right? I want some bread. Dice, Okay. Yes. Can I get a piece of bread? Right. But we cannot say, I want two breads, three breads. No. Así no lo podemos decir porque la regla nos está diciendo acá. Hey, miren, no lo usen. Right. No lo podemos decir. ¿Por qué? Porque ese siempre es singular. Como es singular.
O sea, solo tamaño menciona.
Solo vamos a decir como el tamaño, un pedazo, una pieza, right? That's what we're going to say. Un poco de pan, some bread, pero no vamos a utilizar un número porque no lo podemos pluralizar. Mira acá, estas son como las cosas que tengas que recordar. No plural, always a singular, and can I use a, an, or a number. Okay?
Pero sí podemos decir, deme, give me a five piezas de pan, no.
Five pieces of bread, yes, that one you can say it. I would need five pieces of bread, you can say that. Pero ahí ya five está como un quantifier. Five pieces of bread, 5 gallons of milk, 5 glasses of water, right? That one you can say it like that. Very good. Pero así, directamente, 5 breads, no se puede. Okay? More questions about this. I like your questions, Ricardo. Thank you. And Nelson, thank you for your questions. More questions, please. Más preguntas. Porque esto lo vamos a utilizar siempre, siempre, siempre en inglés. Así que pregunten.
Sí, teacher.
Yes, Mr. Palma.
¿Y si fuera una gasolinera a comprar gasolina, cómo fuera?
Oh, you would say, I need some gallons of
gallon.
I need 1, 2, 3 gallons of gas.
Mm-hmm.
Can you put 3 gallons of gas? Yo no sé cuánto lo ponen. ¿Cuánto lo ponen a su carro?
10, 20.
Mucho, pues boost, yeah. Okay. I need 10 gallons of gas. Gallons of gas. Gasoline. The name is gasoline, but in the United States, we only say gas. Gas. So let's use gas. I need some gas.
Thank you.
Let's see. Thank you. We have a question from, we also say liters. Yes. We have liters, like a liter of milk. Right? We also say liters. That is true, Nancy. Like a liter of milk, a gallon of milk. Yes. Another question? Hello, hello, hello. ¿Otra pregunta?
La primera lámina la puede poner, teacher, que no termine de entender la primera.
Yes, yes,
los contables.
Okay. Did you take a screenshot for this one?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. Entonces lo voy a pasar para la siguiente. Give me a moment.
Ese teacher.
Okay. These are countable nouns. Do you have questions about this? Pregunta de este.
Vamos a ocuparse, siempre vamos a ocupar en singular.
These countable nouns, very good question.
Plural, siempre vamos a ocupar are.
With these countable nouns, right? Countable nouns are singulars and plurals. So it means that we can use is or we can use are, right? Esos son, se transforman. Sí, se transforman porque estos sí pueden ser singulares y plurales. Okay? Right? We can have both singulars and plural. Right? So in this case, we can use is and are. Cuando se usa el ati y tres. Oh, okay. Nancy, in this case, right, when we say a tree, two trees, look at this. When we have a tree, it's only one. Okay, only one. Usually in English, we only say a and an para referirnos a uno. Okay. Vamos a utilizar a and an en inglés para referirnos a uno. No decimos one tree. Es más fácil que usted le diga, oh, there was a tree in your house. Okay, there was one tree in your house. Okay. Es más común que utilicemos a and an cuando hablamos en inglés. Pero cuando ya es más de uno, okay, podemos utilizar los números, siempre y cuando sea un sustantivo contable. Vamos a decir, two trees, three trees, four trees, and so on. Okay. I have a cell phone. I have two cell phones. Right? Usualmente no vamos a decir, I have one cell phone. Siempre vamos a utilizar como opción primordial el uso de a or an. Okay, a or an. Esta va a ser como la primera opción que vamos a tener. ¿Pueden decir one tree? Sí se puede decir, pero no es tan común. Okay, sí se puede decir. The book is all, right? Remember when we have a and da, right? Tell me if you have more questions. Nancy, ¿le queda claro, Nancy? Yes, put in the chat. Yes, okay, thank you, Nancy. Okay, any other question? ¿Alguna otra pregunta? ¿Sandra?
No, teacher.
¿No? Okay.
No.
Ricardo. Tengo una más.
Yes.
Vaya, nosotros podemos contar los árboles. Aquí vea, a tree, two trees. Pero, ¿y si es un bosque?
¿Cómo lo? That's a forest. That's a forest. Un bosque. A forest. We can also say a forest. Un bosque. Mm-hmm. Because you're talking about just one. Right? We say a forest. How many forests I have in El Salvador? ¿Cuántos bosques en El Salvador?
Bien poco.
Two or three, right?
Yes.
Like three forests, right? We can count the forests. What we cannot count in the forest, Ricardo, is the nature in the forest. Lo que no podemos contar es la naturaleza en el bosque. But we can count the forest. One forest, two forests, three forests, five forests.
Mm-hmm. Pero en okay. Este caso, que no queremos... que no quisiéramos decir un número o no tenemos el número específico de los árboles, por decirle algo. A lot of trees.
A lot of trees. Mm-hmm. We can use, cuando tenemos algo en el número en específico, a lot of, several, many. Cuando son muchos, ¿verdad? A lot of, several, many. Por ejemplo, yo en una clase tengo más de 60 estudiantes. Digo, I have a lot of students in the morning. I have several students in the morning. I have many students in the morning. Right? Pero cuando tengo pocos y todavía no me he fijado cuántos son, puedo también decir, I have some students. Some students. A few. Ahí van, a few students, right? That's what we say, right? Good question. Look at all the quantifiers. Some, a few, a lot of, several. Tomen nota, please. Those are great questions, Ricardo. Anybody else? Claudia, Eneida, Pedrina, Francis, questions? Juan Josué, ¿va a querer? Questions? No more questions?
No, teacher.
If it is nice? Pregunta, perdón, por favor. Azalia, do you have questions? Sí, Francis?
Entonces, la película de Forrest Gump, ¿qué era? ¿Bosque de qué?
¿La película de qué, perdón?
Forrest Gump.
Oh, Forrest Gump era un nombre. His name was Forrest Gump. Uh-huh. El nombre de él era Forrest Gump. Pero se describe un poquito distinto. Run, Forrest, run. Forrest Gump is a name. It's the name of the person. It's like Francis Humberto. Run, Francis, run.
Se oye igual, pero realmente nada que ver.
No, it's not the same. Uh-huh. Good question, Francis. Okay, another question? No more? Are you sure? Very good. Let me see the others. Para seguir. Abigail, do you have questions? No? Angie, do you have questions?
No, teacher. Thank you.
And Nelson, more questions?
No, teacher. Este, no olvide la asistencia.
Tan chula. Claudia, do you have questions? Claudia?
No, teacher.
No? Okay.
No, teacher.
Emerson, Josué? Questions?
No, teacher.
No, teacher.
Okay. Jennifer? No, ya me dijo que no. Pedrina, no. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna call the attendance and then we're gonna move to the next work here. Let me call the attendance first. Let's see. Uy, I cannot see anymore. Ya estoy quedando choca. Ángela de Jesús Santa María Juárez.
Presente, teacher.
Azalia Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Present, teacher.
Hello. Claudia Janet Ramos Hernández.
Present, teacher.
David Ernesto Quintanilla Martínez. Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Present, teacher.
Eneida Jasmine Hernández Cruz. Francis Humberto Hernández Valle.
Present, teacher.
Franco Damián Vázquez. Franco. Juan Josué Hernández Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Leida Susana Sorto Cuadra.
Present, teacher.
Nancy María Serrano Chocón. Nelson Brian.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Nancy. Nelson Brian Pereira Maravilla.
Present.
Norma Carolina Mata de Chévez. Pedrina Iliana Gómez de Ortega.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ricardo Gabriel Alvarenga Ventura.
I'm here.
Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona.
Present, teacher.
Jennifer Abidaí López.
Oye, él está ahí.
Daniel Antonio García Cortés, José Alfonso Palma Mejía.
Okay,
thank you. Now we have here, we're going to continue working with the next part of the class, right? Here, this is still about uncountable nouns, okay? And these are the ideas that we cannot count, okay? Hay otra parte de los sustantivos que también no contamos, ¿verdad? En inglés, estas palabras no se cuentan. And I need you to pay attention to this, okay? We have uncountable nouns are often. Estos son ejemplos de uncountable nouns, okay? Oh my God, I hate this. Let's see. With these uncountable nouns, we have abstract ideas, so things that we cannot touch, okay? Ideas abstractas, like love, freedom, education, luck, help, beauty, music, thunder. Those are abstract ideas. Ideas abstractas. Esos son ejemplos de uncountable nouns, abstract ideas, things that we cannot touch. If we say love, hate, liberty, right, freedom, we cannot count those ideas. Knowledge, right, so we cannot count them. Made of smaller parts, things that are made of smaller parts, sugar, rice, salt, sand, flour, aunque hacemos las tortillas, flour, dirt, dust, traffic, grass, spaghetti, right? We cannot count the spaghetti. El espagueti, un espagueti, dos espaguetis.
Spaghetti.
Right? Then we have some food that is cut into small parts, bread, fish, cheese, chocolate, meat, bacon, food, ham, liquids and gases, water, milk, wine, oil, coffee, we can count coffee, rain, soup, air, smoke, blood, juice, fog, materials, wood, glass, paper, gold, silver, ice, iron, cotton, wool, and steel. And we have to be careful because these are also uncountable in English. Furniture, advice, work, news, information, luggage, and money. Okay, these are examples. This is vocabulary that you can start using. Okay, es el vocabulario que ya podemos y nosotros incluir en nuestras prácticas. Okay, so please take a screenshot of the examples of uncountable nouns. Estos son ejemplos de uncountable nouns. Okay, so please take a screenshot. ¿Ya tomaron el screenshot?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay.
Teacher, ¿por qué las monedas no se pueden contar? ¿Por qué las monedas no se pueden contar?
Money.
¿A dónde dice moneda?
Money. Dinero.
Ah, but that's money. Money y monedas es distinto. Money es dinero. Monedas is coins. Coins, las monedas sí se pueden contar. One coin.
Pero el dinero no se puede contar.
Pero el dinero no. O sea, la palabra dinero no la puede contar.
¿Cuánto tienes? ¿Mucho o cómo?
How much money do you have? I have a lot of money.
Quiero decir un dólar o...
Ajá, ahí está hablando, ahí está usando dólares. I have $100. No está diciendo I have 100 monies.
Ah, o sea que si usa la palabra money, ¿sí? No puede incluir una
número.
Cantidad específica.
Exacto, Sandra, eso es correcto. Exacto, pero si usted ya dice $100, usted no está usando money, está usando dollars.
Con esa palabra específica no se puede usar.
Exacto, entonces yo le puedo preguntar, Sandra, how much money do you have?
A lot of money.
A lot of money. O me puede decir, I have $100.
Okay.
Porque estoy preguntando cuánto dinero tiene. How much money do you have? I have nothing. I have $1. I have a few cents. Okay.
Y no se puede decir solo $1. Que no lleves half.
Sí, puede decirlo. Puede decirlo. $1. How much money do you have? $1. Right.
Más corta la respuesta.
Es más corta, pero mi deber es decirle la respuesta larga. Porque estamos en beginners.
Ajá, lo bueno es que le entiende.
Sí. Okay. Do you have more questions about the examples?
Yo.
Ajá, Emerson.
En el caso de la palabra thunder, vaya, el trueno como tal sí sé que no se puede contabilizar, pero podemos decir dos truenos, tres truenos, entonces sí ya se vuelve algo contable.
A lot of thunders. It's a lot of thunder. It's a thunder night. But you cannot say one thunder, two thunders. Porque en español sí podemos, pero en inglés no podemos. Thundercat. Es el cartoon. En español sí podemos decir un trueno, dos truenos, tres truenos. But in English we can't. We cannot use thunder with one thunder, two thunders, three thunders. Some thunders. A lot of thunders.
Que en español son diferentes.
Yes, of course. Of course. Many, many, many. Muchísimas. Muchísimas cosas que son distintas en inglés que en español. Por ejemplo, en español decimos un café. Right? But in English, we can say a cup of coffee. Para decir uno, tengo que decir primero a cup of coffee. Una taza de café. Right? Para especificar que es uno. I always tell my husband, hey, can you give me some coffee? Right? So he gives me coffee. Okay? Pero sí, hay muchas cosas que son distintas. Decimos, yo quiero una lechita en la mañana, right? But in English, we don't say una lechita, right? I need a glass of milk.
Milk.
Yes, exactly. Very good. More questions? Can I continue?
Continue.
Continue? Okay, let's go. We're going to practice a small conversation right now. Eso se los explico porque vamos a utilizar there is and there are. Recuérdense, ¿ok? There is and there are. So, we have a conversation here with there is and there are that, well, we have some examples that Ricardo and Josué are going to help me. Ricardo, you are Will. Josué, you're Tania. All right, let's see your pronunciation. Let's listen to your pronunciation.
Okay. Oh, can you help me? Where is the Milburn building? I don't live here.
Don't worry. They are four buildings. Which one do you need?
A girl told me to go to the building on Main Street.
Ignore it. It's down the street on the left side.
Thanks. I have to ask you else. Is there a training center?
There are a lot of training centers on the building between Main and King Street.
I have some interviews there. Thanks. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Okay, very good job, very good job. Let's practice some of the words that we're going to work here, right? Let me put them here.
Something. Training. Between.
Very good. Let's practice this, and we're going to practice phrases that we are going to use a lot, okay? Okay, let's practice the first one. Can you help me? Can you help me?
Can you help me?
Can you help me?
Can you help me?
Right, that is a common phrase. That's a common phrase to ask for help. Well, usted necesita ayuda. Can you help me? Right?
Can you help me?
Okay. Then we go with building.
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 Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Worry.
Like the sun, don't worry.
Like your...
Be happy. Don't worry.
Don't worry.
I know it.
Ask you.
Something else. Between interviews. Okay, we have two pronunciations. In American English, we say interviews. Okay, interviews. In British English, we can say interviews. Okay. En americano, interviews. En británico, interviews. Okay. Interviews. Okay. Now, let's see. Now that we have practiced this pronunciation, I need you to help me, Azalia. You are Will. And Claudia, you are Tania.
Okay. Hello. Can you help me? Where is the Melbourne building? I don't live here.
Sorry, there are four buildings. Which one do you need?
A girl told me to go to the building on Main Street.
I know it. It's down the street. On the left side.
Thanks. I had to ask you something else. Is there a training center?
There are a lot of training centers on the building between Main and King Street.
I have some interview there. Thank you again. Bye-bye.
Very good job. Just practice interviews. Repeat after me, Azalia. Interviews. Very good. Interviews. Mm-hmm. Very good. One pair more. Let's practice Sandra Gladys. And let's practice here Nelson. Sandra, your Will, Nelson, your Tania.
Okay. Hello, can you help me? What is the Melbourne building? I don't like here.
Don't worry. There are four buildings. Which one do you need?
A girl told me to go to the building on Main Street.
I know it's down the street on the left side.
Thanks. I had to ask you something else. Is there a training center?
There are a lot of training centers on the building between King Street.
I have some interviews there. Thank you. Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, very good. Now, I need you to practice, Nelson, this question. Which one do you need? Repeat. Nelson?
Which one do you need?
Exactly.
Which one do you need?
Which one do you need? Coffee or water?
Coffee.
Which one?
Coffee.
Coffee, of course, right? Good. Usted de los míos. Okay, very good.
Which one do you need?
Coffee or water? Which one do you need? A computer or a cell phone? Which one do you need? Dollars or food? Right? And then we continue. Now, with this conversation here, we're going to practice. Let's keep working here a little bit more. Right? With the next part. In pairs, because this conversation is on your module book, in pairs, we're going to practice the conversation. And we are going to answer the three questions. Please read for me, Leida, question number one. Leida? Not here, Leida. Mr. Palma, read question number one.
Full money, the learning building are there.
Very good. Repeat after me, Mr. Palma. How many?
How many?
How?
How?
How many?
How many?
Very good. Number two, Pedrina.
Where is they building? Where wants to go? Located.
Located. Repeat.
Located.
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 Very good. Juan Josué, number three.
How many training centers are there? Where are they?
Where are they? Very good. Where are they? Now, based on the conversation, based on this conversation, you are going to answer these three questions. And you are going to practice, of course, the conversation. This conversation is on unit four on your book, right? So we're going to start. Do we understand what we're going to do? ¿Se entiende qué vamos a hacer? First, we are going to practice the conversation. Second, we are going to answer the questions, okay? Two things. Practicar y responder. Todos los libros están en el portal, en la plataforma, Nancy. Váyase a la plataforma y ahí puede descargar la unidad 4. Solo le sale una página. Really? ¿Solo una le sale? Let me send you right now the book. Don't worry. Eso no es problema. Aquí lo tenemos. I am going to send it to the chat. Okay. I can't. I changed my phone. Mm-hmm. I changed my phone. Give me a moment. Yeah, I'm gonna put the questions. Voy a poner la pregunta aquí, las preguntas y la... Please take a screenshot. If you don't have it, take a screenshot.
Mm-hmm.
Now take another screenshot.
Yes.
¿Todos lo tienen? Nancy?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Okay, very good. Now let's go. We're gonna get to work right now. We're going to work for a few minutes. Yes, yes. Okay, thank you, Nancy. Okay, let's go. We're going to work in pairs. Choose your group. Click on the button. Click on the button. Click, click, click. Click, 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 click. Thank you, click. Angie, Franco, Josué.
Voy a hacer Tania y después voy a hacer el otro. Creo que tenemos tiempo.
Yes, you have time.
Ok. Entonces yo empiezo.
Ajá.
Ok. Hello, can you help me? Where is the Melbourne building? I don't like here.
I don't live. Live.
I don't live here.
I don't live here. Exacto. Live es como decir en vivo.
Espéreme, Sandra, que que la copié aquí. Pues ya no lo... Permítame, Sandra, que voy a buscarla en la que él.
Me avisa.
Pedrina, ya la tiene. ¿Qué le pasó? No le escuchamos absolutamente nada, Pedrina.
Se le habrá ido el audio.
¿Lo apagó el audio? Pedrina. Pedrina, enciende el audio, por favor.
Permítame, teacher, que no encuentro la copia del diálogo.
Aquí se la voy a poner yo, no se preocupe, tómale otra captura.
Vaya, vaya, por favor.
Si no, nunca vamos a trabajar.
Sí, sí, sí. Aquí mejor está. Lo hago en el teléfono, se me hace mucho más fácil.
Terrible. La segunda, teacher, perdón que le pregunte.
Uh-huh.
La segunda pregunta tiene dos veces QR. Tengo
una foto.
Uh-huh. No la entiendo.
Ya le voy a explicar.
¿Dónde está el edificio? Dice.
Ya le voy a explicar. ¿Ya le tomo la captura de pantalla, Pedro?
Sí.
¿Ya las preguntas?
Las preguntas, sí, esas las tengo en el libro.
Ah, vale. Perfecto. Ahora, yo le explico acá porque tiene where. En where. Dice, where is the building? Right. Where Will wants to go located. Esta parte se la voy a explicar así, mire. Esta parte que está poniendo acá, que donde tiene el otro where,
uh-huh.
Where Will wants to go, esta parte es opcional. Where is the building located? Esa es la pregunta. Where is the building located?
Okay.
Esta parte, where Will wants to go, is extra information. I am giving extra information to be more specific. Como un complemento, exacto. Entonces, esta parte prácticamente me está dando más detalles del building, del edificio que yo quiero saber dónde está localizado. Entonces, prácticamente yo le estoy ayudando a esa persona a que se ponga más en contexto de lo que yo quiero decir. Where is the building where... Will wants to go. Where is the building where Sandra lives located? ¿Dónde está el edificio donde vive Sandra? Right? Quiero saber un poquito. Yo estoy dando más información hacia la otra persona se le hace más fácil decirme la información que yo quiero. ¿Ok?
Gracias.
Ahora sí, ¿o no?
Ahora sí.
Dígame. Dígame. Ahora sí, Sandra. ¿O todavía no?
Sí.
Sí. Sí. Pregúnteme. Okay. Ok. Very good. Let's practice then. Yo la puedo estar escuchando acá.
Vaya, Sandra.
Ok. Empiezo entonces nuevamente.
Vaya, sí, sí, por favor.
Hello. Hello. Can you help me? Where is the Melbourne building? I don't like here.
Do not worry, there are four buildings on do you know?
A girl told me to go to the building on May Street.
I think it is wrong, take street on the left side.
Thank you. I have to ask you something else. Is there a train?
Any questions?
Where is building here with where to go to the tank?
Esta creo que es la que dice it is down the street on the left side. Ah, sí. I know it. Él está preguntando a dónde está el edificio. A qué building tiene que ir. Mm-hmm. Perdón, a qué building.
¿Con quién estaba, Salia? No lo escucho.
Solita.
No le tocó con nadie.
Uh-uh.
Ah, pues no, alguien se salió. Cabalito. Sí, alguien se salió. Porque habíamos cabal 16. Let me put you in another group, okay? I'm going to send you to this group. Go.
Y en sí. La parte donde está la conversación de dice, Tania dice, I know it is done, the story, on the left side.
La chica dice de qué, del edificio del Main Street. I know, I don't the street on the left side. Ah, no, es el que dice. Que no entiendo. No sé cuál es este.
Dale, ya me esperan. Tanto. Dice, güey, ¿dónde está la niña? Y donde está la parte donde dice Tania también, the alone on training center.
Fui a pasear, teacher.
Quiero ver. Sí, es que se salieron dos personas. Okay, let's continue. You have there the practice. Angie, what is the question for, what is the answer for question number one? There are four what? Complete yes. Answers.
There are four building.
Buildings.
Building. Uh-huh.
Okay. Lea la pregunta, la respuesta completa. How many Melbourne buildings are there, Angie?
How many
No, contéstame la pregunta. How many Melbourne buildings are there?
There are four buildings.
Very good. There are four buildings.
Building.
Haga de cuenta y caso que la U no existe. Okay?
Okay, building.
Buildings. Very good.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Number two, Azalia. Where is the building where Will wants to go located? Azalia?
Se me olvida.
Where is the building where Will wants to go located?
There are.
No. Number two.
Where is the building where Will
wants to go located? Mm-hmm.
There are?
No.
I cannot eat.
Is the building on May Street?
Okay. Let's see the conversation, okay? Sandra is going to help you, Azalia, don't worry. Now, we look here. Right. The question is, where is the building where Will wants to go located? Right. We ask, we see here for Will, a girl told me to go to the building on Main Street. Right. Okay.
Okay.
Where is the building where Will wants to go located? Sandra, what do you have? What is the answer, Sandra? What is your answer, Sandra? ¿Qué tiene usted? Claro.
Tú. Is the building on May Street?
Okay. It's on Main Street. It's on Main Street.
Left side.
Oh, it is on May Street.
Tenemos aquí, vamos a completar la respuesta. It is. Okay. The building, it's on Main Street. It's down the street on the left side. Esa es toda la respuesta. It's on Main Street. It's down the street on the left side.
On the left side.
Very good. Now, let's continue. Thank you, Azalia. Thank you, Sandra. How many training centers are there? Where are they, Josué?
Okay, there are a lot of training. It's between Main and King Street.
Okay. Okay, there are a lot of training centers and they are on the building between Main and King Street. Remember, if you say a lot of, you're going to use they. Okay, they are. Porque no podemos decir it is on, porque son muchos. Recuerden, están localizados. Están localizados. Okay, good. Let's continue working. Questions about this? Yes?
Que no me queda. They are between.
¿Cuál era la? They are
on the building between Main and King Street. They are on the building.
On the building between May and King Street.
Exactly. Okay, let's continue.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Well, yesterday we have this with there is and there are, right? Now, what we're going to do right now is that in pairs, we are going to create, we have there is, there are, right? We're going to create three examples for there is and three examples for there are, okay? So we are going to use all the vocabulary that we know, all the vocabulary we remember, and we are going to use these examples too, okay? Vamos a trabajar. Ahora vamos a crear tres ejemplos con there is, tres ejemplos con there are. Vamos a hacer seis ejemplos en total, right? Six in total, using there is and there are, okay? There are. Now, we're going to do that in pairs. Use all the vocabulary in your company, all the vocabulary in your life. You can use countable nouns, uncountable nouns with no problems, okay? To use there is and there are, okay? Now, vamos a hacer los seis ejemplos, tres y tres, right? Solamente tres y tres, to work together. Do you have a question about what we're going to do? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta lo que vamos a hacer? ¿Cuál es su pregunta, Ricardo?
No,
vamos a hacer con cosas que podemos contar y podemos contar y vamos a utilizar el there is o there are. ¿Es así?
Ajá. Sí, there is y there are. Vamos a hacer tres con there is y tres con there are. Tres con there is y tres con there are. Al final van a tener seis ejemplos. Por eso van a trabajar en pareja. Pero antes de eso, déjenme tomarle la asistencia rapidito. Ángela de Jesús Santa María Juárez.
Presente.
Azalia Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Presente.
Claudia Jeanette Ramos Hernández.
Presente, teacher.
Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Presente, teacher.
Eneida Yasmith Hernández Cruz. Francis Humberto Hernández Valle.
Present, teacher.
Franco Damián Vázquez.
Present, teacher.
Juan Josué Hernández Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Leida Susana Sorto. Nancy María Serrano Chacón. Leida.
Present.
Thank you. Thank you. Nelson Brian Pereira Maravilla.
Present, teacher.
Norma Carolina Mata de Chévez. Pedrina Iliana Gómez Ortega.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ricardo Gabriel Berengue Ventura.
I'm here.
Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona.
Present, teacher.
Jennifer Abidaí López Escoto. Jennifer, ¿cómo está?
Present.
Hello, José Alfonso Palma Mejía.
Present. Okay.
Very good, thank you so much. Now let's get to work right now. We're going to work again in pairs, right? In pairs to complete this activity. ¿Alguna pregunta antes que vayamos a hacer la actividad? No? ¿No hay preguntas?
Teacher, a mí se me cortó un poquito. ¿Vamos a hacer oraciones normales o preguntas?
Only sentences. Only sentences. No questions. Okay, only sentences. Okay. Yes.
Bueno.
Good question. Pues. Good question. No vamos a trabajar con las mismas personas. Vamos a trabajar con personas distintas. So, let's get to work here. Give me a moment. Very good. Okay. Let's start right now. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Let's choose our teams. Let's choose our teams, let's go. Angie, choose your team, Angie.
No es negativa, ¿no?
Yes, como there is o there are.
Solo. Okay.
There is
a car.
Sí, there is a car.
There is a
car on the street. On the street.
On the qué?
On the street.
On the qué, on the street. Francis? ¿Cómo
on
era?
There is a car. On the street.
¿Y cómo dijimos ayer que vamos a pronunciar on the street? Es que él me está diciendo otra cosa y yo le dije a él que no es así. Francis.
Strip.
Es que strip, Francis, ya le conté que strip.
Strip.
Es de unos muchachos y unas muchachas que ganan más que nosotros. Todas las noches.
On the strip.
Strip.
Street. No, que strip.
Strip.
Escuche, Francis, de nuevo, vamos otra vez. Calle se dice street.
Strip.
No.
Café, strip.
Vaya, míreme bien. No junte sus labios al terminar la palabra. Diga street.
Street.
Exacto. Si usted junta sus labios y dice strip, es otra palabra que no tiene nada que ver con lo que estamos haciendo.
Street.
Ajá, ahí es perfecto como lo acabo de decir. Very good. Si no, cuando suba el video a YouTube, no me lo van a dejar pasar por ese otro vocabulario.
No, hombre.
Street.
Es que tal vez sale uno aquí del grupo. Street.
Repítalo.
Tampoco.
Yo no excluyo a nadie. Todos los trabajos son buenos. Pero la palabra correcta es street.
Street.
Exacto. Dígala.
Street.
Exacto. Si dice de nuevo la misma palabra, ahí me avisan ustedes dos, por favor.
Ok.
Ahí me di cuenta. Good morning. Good afternoon.
Good morning, teacher.
Good evening. Did you finish?
No.
Iniciando, vamos.
Okay. Do you have questions?
Pero ahorita yo creo que no. Yo no, personalmente.
And you, Nelson?
Pues yo solo, verdad, quería mencionar que si no hay problema, que solo usemos casi igual como el ejemplo que está ahí, de que las oraciones van acompañadas de preposiciones.
No hay ningún problema. Mejor. No hay problema.
Eso era.
Ok, very good. See you in a moment then. See you in a moment. Okay. Un ratito.
Hey.
Bye. ¿Cómo era? ¿Era between?
Ajá. De.
Do you have questions?
Aparecieron dos más. Ahorita va. Está apareciendo Nancy. Estaba solita.
Ay, sí. No, es que se cayó. Bueno, a mí se me cayó la internet y creo que también
a Leida, ¿verdad?
A mi compañera se le cayó.
¿Verdad que con Leida estaba?
No. Con Astar. No, sí, con Leida. No. Pero se le cayó el internet.
Sale aquí.
Igual está. Que a mí se me había caído. No estaba con Azalia. Con Ángela estaba.
Ay, aquí está la Angie. Ya llegó la Angie. La voy a mandar con la Angie entonces porque ahí llegó allá. Me acabo de ver quién se acaba de conectar. Te voy a mandar con ella hoy.
Bueno.
Do you have any questions, girls?
Yo entiendo que tres oraciones en singular y tres en plural. Plural.
Uh-huh. Exactly. ¿Cuáles son sus ejemplos?
And there is. Hemos hecho cortas.
No importa.
Corta.
There is a pretty baby.
There is a pretty baby. ¿En dónde?
In my house.
Very good. There is a pretty baby in my house.
There is a car on the street.
There is a car on the street. Very good. That is perfect.
There is a lamb.
Si gusta, diga la otra.
There is a lamb in my bedroom. Uh-huh.
There is a lamb.
A lamb in my bedroom.
In my bedroom.
Bedroom.
In my bedroom. Bedroom.
Bedroom.
Vaya, Pedrina, usted para practicar inglés. Permítame refrasear mi consejo. Para que usted vaya mejorando su pronunciación en inglés, necesito que abra la boca. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Ok. Porque usted no abre la boca. Entonces, yo necesito que usted me ayude y abra la boca cuando habla. Exacto. Okay. Sin pena. Aquí no importa lo que los demás nos digan. ¿Ok? Nuestra meta es aprender inglés. ¿Ok? Una pantalla nos está dividiendo. Entonces, no hay ningún problema. Okay. Usted va a decir, my name is.
My name is.
Mire qué bonito se escucha cuando usted abre la boca. Pero cuando usted no abre la boca, se dice, my name is. Se oye cortado.
Porque
lo está diciendo con pena. Recuérdese, todos sus compañeros acá son de nivel 1. ¿Ok? Ninguno está en nivel 2, que quisieran, pero no lo están. Están en nivel 1. Entonces, todos vamos a ir aprendiendo. Entonces, yo necesito que cuando usted participe, me abra la boca, porque usted me está leyendo de esta manera. Mire, Pedrina. Me está leyendo. There is an A. T-M-A. Y así no va a aprender. Tiene que abrir la boca así. There is an ATM across the street.
Este se ve diferente su rostro cuando abre más la boca, como que se alegra más de que lo dijo más bonito, más bien.
Que lo dijo más bonito, exacto. Sí. Eso estamos practicando ahorita con Azalea. Ella también está abriendo la boca para pronunciar mejor.
Okay.
Totalmente nos va a costar más, así que no se preocupen. O sea, ahorita estamos aprendiendo. Y nos va a costar por lo menos unos 6 meses irnos acostumbrando nuestros músculos de la boca a pronunciar inglés. ¿Ok?
Okay.
Perfecto. Okay. Ya creo que nos quedan 20 segundos, así que nos vamos. Léame su último ejemplo, Azalea. O Pedrina.
There are apples in the box of fruits.
Okay, there are manzanas, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Apples.
Yes.
Apples. There are in the box. ¿Cuántas apples? No se vayan todavía.
Solo manzanas.
There are, entonces diga, there are some apples.
Some apples in the box of fruit.
Pero usted puede decir solamente, Azalea, there are some apples in the fridge. In the fridge. In the fridge.
Sin necesidad del box of.
Sí, en la caja del freezer, no. There are some apples in the fridge. Okay. Léame el último. Creo que quedan 10 segundos.
There are some apples in the fridge.
Okay, perfecto. Vámonos entonces con los demás. Let's go. Okay, Now we are going to listen to the examples. Each one of you is going to give me one example using there is or there are. Okay? Escojan el ejemplo con el que se siente más cómodo o escogen con el que tienen duda, que no saben si está bien o está mal. Okay? Let's start with Jennifer Abidail. Read your example, Jennifer.
Una. One.
Only one, yes.
There are apples in the box.
There are apples in the box. Okay, there are apples in the box. Very good. No se vale repetir, okay? Así que van a buscar otros ejemplos parecidos. Thank you. Emerson, what's your example? Si los miro dormidos, les vuelvo a preguntar. Ajá. Emerson.
Está dormido, teacher, porque tiene el micrófono apagado.
Singular sería, perdón, no me he fijado.
What's your example, Emerson?
There is a bank between the supermarket and the mall.
Very good job. There is a bank between the supermarket and the mall. Excellent job. Ya estamos combinando el there is con las direcciones. Very good. Prepositions of place. That's excellent. Claudia Janet. Or Janet. Hi, Janet.
Hi, teacher.
What's your example?
There is an ATM in Caja de Crédito San Agustín.
Okay, very good. There is an ATM. Very good. But that sounds like the one in the book. Tell me another one.
There's a municipal complex on the corner of First Street East.
Very good. That's much better. Excellent job, Claudia. Very good. Azalia, give us your example. You are on mute, Azalia.
De cualquier lugar. There is a pretty baby in my house.
There is a pretty baby in my house. Excellent job, Azalia. Very good. There is a pretty baby in my house. Very good. Palma, go ahead.
There are many people.
There are many people where? Where? There are many people. Me deja medias. ¿Dónde hay muchas personas? Where there are many people?
My work. In my work.
In my work. Okay, in my work. Okay, very good. In my work. Okay. Continue. Let's see, Pedrina.
This a lamp in my brick.
Okay. There is a lamp in my bedroom.
Bedroom.
Okay, repeat. There is a lamp in my bedroom.
There is a lamp in my bedroom.
Very good, Pedrina. Very good. Nancy. Nancy, your microphone. Nancy.
There are strip, Juan Pablo II.
Okay, one more time.
There are the strip Juan Pablo II.
No. ¿Qué hay en la calle? ¿Qué hay en la Juan Pablo?
tiendas.
Ok, armemos una oración todos. Ok. She's telling us right now, there are.
There are money.
There are sure. Something in Juan Pablo Street. Street. Nancy Street. Wow. What's there? There are. Me falta qué es lo que hay.
Shop.
Shops. Okay, very good, Pedrina. There are shops in Juan Pablo Street. Okay. Me tiene que decir qué es lo que hay, no solamente usar el there are y el lugar. No, me tiene que decir qué es lo que hay. ¿Ok? There are streets, there are shops in Juan Pablo Street. ¿Ok? In Juan Pablo Street. Now, let's continue. Let's continue. Ricardo, go ahead.
Hey, there are many students in my classroom.
There are many?
Students in my classroom.
Very good. There are many students in my classroom. Excellent job, Francis.
Okay. There is a lamp in my bedroom.
No, ya lo dijo Pedrina. Dígame otra.
There are a lot of buildings in the Escalón.
In Escalón neighborhood. Very good. In Escalón neighborhood. Aquí se lo voy a poner. Very good. Very good. Excellent. Francis, neighbor. Uf, espérame. No, sí, no es. Neighborhood. Neighborhood. Thank you, Francis. Sandra. Your example?
There are some pieces of the bread to dinner.
There are some
pieces of bread to dinner.
Okay. There are some pieces of bread for the dinner. Of
soup.
Okay.
Soup.
No. Listen. There are some pieces of bread for the dinner.
For the dinner.
For okay. The dinner. Josué. Thank you. That's a nice sentence.
Okay. There are banks in the building in front of the police.
Okay. There are. Okay.
They are.
There are.
There are.
Okay, very good. There are. Leida. Hi, Leida. Don't fall asleep.
Hi. Medio entendí porque me iba conectando, así que hice there are computers in GEA El Salvador.
Okay, very good. Very good, that's correct. Very good. There are computers. Repeat, Leida. Computers.
Computers.
Computers. Angie?
Hello, teacher.
Read your example, Angie.
Teacher, ¿me escucha? Yo no.
Diga su ejemplo, Angie.
Okay. There are two shoes store in the mall.
Okay. Very good, Angie. Thank you so much. Nelson?
Thank you.
Nelson?
Yes, teacher. Wow. There are many restaurants near the hospital.
Okay, very good. There are many restaurants near the hospital. Prepositions, very good. Emerson Javier, give me another example.
Okay, teacher. There are many people in the bank.
There are many people in the bank. Thank you, Emerson. Franco? Franco. Okay, no Franco. Let's continue.
Hi, teacher. Okay, there are three women in my family.
There are?
There are three women in my family.
Okay, there are three. That's a good sentence, Franco, but it's there are three women. Women.
Women.
Mm-hmm. In my family.
Plural, okay.
Okay, women in my family. Woman is one. Women is
okay.
Two, three, four, five. Okay.
Two, three, four, five. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Very good. Ya se los puse en el chat, el plural y el singular de mujer. And Claudia, you're the last one. Go ahead. Ah, no, ya le pregunté a Claudia. Okay, so let's continue. Let's continue
here. Se está durmiendo, pregúntelo otra vez.
Sí, se está durmiendo, cabal.
Oh.
Igual que Emerson.
No, okay. Me había preguntado.
Let's see this example. I need you to look at this. We're going to do this together. And look, it says, complete the sentence with there is or there are in positive or negative. Right, and we're going to make questions right now. Two questions. Okay, two questions. Now, the first one, what would you put in number one? It says a jacket. A jacket. What goes here? If we use there is and there are.
There is.
Very good. There is.
A jacket.
There is a jacket. Very good. What about five books?
There aren't five books.
There aren't five books. There are four books. Very good. Now let's try to make questions. How do you think the questions are going to be made? ¿Cómo creen que se hacen las preguntas?
Are there?
Excellent.
Are there?
And look at this. Are there?
Are there chairs?
Are there some? Ahora viene, viene algo. Cuando tenemos una pregunta, ¿verdad? Y la respuesta va a ser, there are some chairs. Para preguntas, vamos a utilizar la palabra any. ¿Ok? Any. Are there any chairs? Okay. Para preguntas, para decir, ¿hay algunas sillas? O hay sillas. Are there any chairs? Are there any students in the class? Are there any discounts in the mall? Are there any good offers in the store? Okay. Any. Siempre utilizamos any para negativos o para preguntas. Okay. Write that down. And then we have milk. What can we put with milk?
There is.
It's a question. It's a question, Mr. Palma.
Is there milk?
¿Cuál es la palabra que vamos a utilizar para preguntas?
Is there any milk?
Okay, yes, there is, no, there isn't. Very simple. Now, let me ask you a question. The word jacket. Look at the word jacket. Is that countable or uncountable?
Countable.
Very good. What about the word books? Countable or uncountable?
Countable.
What about chairs? Countable or uncountable?
Countable.
What about milk? Countable or uncountable?
Uncountable.
Excellent. Very good job. Very good job. Just give me one second.
Uncountable.
Yes.
Teacher.
Yes.
Bueno, ahí dice peinado, ¿verdad? No dice cabellos.
¿A dónde?
En chairs.
Yeah.
Ah, no, son sillas.
Ah, sí, ya, perdón. Uh-huh. El sueño.
Want some coffee? Okay. Okay, no. Chairs, silla. Hairs, hair is uncountable. This is my hair. No se puede decir cabellos. Dice cabello. Okay? More okay. Questions? Do we understand this exercise?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. Let's continue. Let's continue working. Let me show you the next activity. I want to show you something with a lot of quantifiers, okay? No se me vayan a asustar, solo se los quiero mostrar. Tomen un screenshot y lo tienen ahí guardado because it's gonna help you in the future. Can you see this? Okay. We're gonna have the quantifiers here. We have there is and there are for quantifiers. Right? And if you can see, we have there a lot of quantifiers that we can use, right? Can you see them right now on the screen? Los ven, no, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Now, what are the quantifiers that you can see there, Ricardo?
Quantifiers again?
¿Cuáles son los quantifiers que puede ver usted? Al inicio de la clase yo les digo algunos. ¿Cuáles son los que usted puede ver?
Ya no veo.
We have, no, sorry, que la pantalla se puso negra. We have in quantifiers, we have no, any, a little, right? A bit of, less, some. Solo denme un segundo que se arregle la compu. Ya le voy a mostrar un segundito. Déjenme. Ya está negra la compu. Ni los miro, ni. ¿Ustedes me miran? ¿Me escuchan?
No, pichín. Sí. No la haces.
Sí, me miran.
Yes.
Ya me estoy durmiendo, Tiberia no la veía.
¿Qué pasa?
Ay, no, Angie. Coffee necesito.
Vale,
es que por no levantarme no he ido, pero sí lo necesitaba desde que me sentí acá.
Voy a traerlo.
Todos necesitamos café. Una ronda para todos, por favor.
Y sí, okay, tráiganos a todos. Sí.
Necesitamos café.
Ahí se los compartimos.
Que apenas es miércoles. Comercial para mientras seguimos. Comercial para mientras seguimos. Recuérdense que ya mañana es el último día para entregar las actividades. No se olviden de eso. Tomorrow is the last day. Ok, se los voy a mostrar de nuevo. Sí.
No, pero actividades de las tareas.
Sí. De esa semana.
Sí. Ah, es que sí las he hecho.
Yo me acuerdo que
pero el examen lo podemos hacer el viernes.
Todo tienen que entregar mañana. Si no entregan nada mañana, ya se quedan sin nota. Se va a aplazar.
Tomorrow, lo mando.
No, I was showing you here. We have here the quantifiers, right? And these are the quantifiers that we're going to use. I'm going to show you here. With the ones that we have here for there is, we're going to have these quantifiers, okay? These are the quantifiers we will use for there is, okay? Now, for there are, we are going to use these other quantifiers for there are. Right? And we also have the definitions for each. For example, right here, let me show you in. For the word no, right? This is a quantifier. Give me one second. I don't like that color. For the word no, we have zero. That's the definition, zero. Okay. For the word any, the definition is an amount more than zero, negative or question, right? That is. Now, my question is, am I going to use any with there are? Am I going to use any with there are? Según la tabla, ¿puedo utilizar any con there are? Exactly, Ricardo, we can't. No vamos a utilizar any con no, there are. No. We are not going to use it, okay? We are not going to use it. Now let me do something here. This is better. This is going to be this, right?
O sea, teacher, que there is, vamos a usar los que están en la lista.
Exactly. These are examples.
There are solo a few, several people, y los otros que están abajo. Solo eso vamos a usar con there are.
Exactly. Exactly. Okay. Those are the ones that we're going to use. And these are the definitions. Estas son las definiciones de cada uno de ellos. Okay. For there is, I have zero. For any, I have an amount more than zero. For a little and a few, it's a small amount. Okay. Para a little bit, a bit of, several, is a small amount. Less and fewer, smaller than that amount. And so on. Okay. Así es como van divididos cada uno de ellos. Please, right now, if you can, take a screenshot. Ahora que ya están divididos, por favor. Tomen una captura para que vean, cómo está dividido cada uno. Okay. Si se fijan, hay más para there is que para there are, ¿verdad? Hay muchos más. ¿Y qué significa, many? Ah, many significa a big amount. ¿Y qué significa a few? A small amount. Right? And so on. Now, this is just... ¿Cómo?
Y en Spanish, a few?
Un poco, no sé, no.
Ah,
no
le puedo, ¿o en qué ocasiones? Ajá, okay, ¿o en qué ocasiones se van a ocupar, teacher?
For example... When we have, let's, right now I have many students in my class, right?
Many, a few?
Listen. Right now I have many students in my class. I have 16 students. But yesterday I had a few students. I only had 6 students. Okay? Entonces tuve menos. Menos de la cantidad. Tuve pocos. Entonces tengo 6. Ahora tengo many, ayer tenía few. Okay?
A few. Okay.
Today. Son pocos. Okay. Si me dicen que les traduzca, no puedo traducirles. Me muero de hambre como traductora, lo siento.
Yesterday.
Okay. Now, let's continue working. I'm going to show you here, right? Some examples. Well, these are examples from the book, right? But I want to show you also that we can use, with there is and there are, we can use adjectives, right? What are adjectives? Adjectives are those words that we use to describe things, people, places. For example, I can describe Nelson's house, right? Nelson's house, it looks pretty, right? Pretty sería un adjetivo. Right, pretty. Nelson's house looks organized. Otro adjetivo. The wall in Sandra's house is green. Estamos utilizando un color para describir, es un adjetivo. Right? Vamos a utilizar adjetivos para describir cosas, ¿verdad? Y ahora vamos a combinar adjetivos y el uso de there is and there are. Okay? Let me show you right now. Okay. We have adjectives that are positive and adjectives that are negatives. Okay. Now we have adjectives before nouns. Look at the words here in the examples. Look at the words. In the examples, we have there are. Excuse me one second. There are comfortable rooms. Comfortable rooms. Okay. There are comfortable rooms. There is a huge parking lot. Ahora ya le estamos describiendo los nouns que nosotros escogimos, ¿verdad? Los nouns que nosotros escogimos anteriormente, que era, por ejemplo, rooms. Ya lo estoy describiendo con la palabra comfortable. Parking lot. Now I'm saying, oh, there is a huge parking lot. Or we can say, there is a small parking lot, right? There are nice places to rest. Nice places. There is an illuminated training room. The adjective, illuminated, right? So these words, each one of them, they describe things in a nice way. They are positive, right? Then we have negative adjectives. There is a narrow reception area. Narrow, el adjetivo es narrow. The adjective is narrow. There are small offices. Small offices in my company. Ay, vamos a decir que son adjetivos negativos or negative adjectives cuando están describiendo una cualidad o una característica de algún lugar de trabajo que no es tan buena. Okay? There is a disgusting kitchen area. Disgusting. There is a smelly living room. Cuando alguien tira algo hediondo en el living room. Okay. So, what are the adjectives? Comfortable. Please repeat with me. Comfortable.
Comfortable.
Huge.
Huge. Huge.
Nice.
Nice.
Illuminated.
Illuminated.
Narrow.
Narrow.
Small.
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 Disgusting.
Disgusting.
Smelly.
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 No. Smelly.
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 Very good. Now you only the girls. Only the girls. Only the women. Over there, the women. Comfortable.
Comfortable.
Only the women. Only the women. Comfortable.
Comfortable.
Only the women.
Solo las niñas.
Ya les dije qué significa women. Okay. Only the women. Comfortable.
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 Huge.
Huge.
Huge. Nice.
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 Illuminated.
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 Narrow.
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 Small.
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 No more. Small.
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 Small. Porque si dicen mall, es un centro comercial, y aquí que debemos decir pequeño. Small.
Small.
Small. Small. Disgusting.
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 Smelly.
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 Smelly. Okay, very good. Thank you, girls. Now, the man. The man in this classroom, please repeat with me. Comfortable.
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 Okay. Huge.
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 Nice.
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 Only the men, Azalea.
Only the men.
Only the men. Nice.
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 Illuminated. Ya le vamos a poner mute a la sala, pero. Narrow.
Narrow.
Small.
Small.
Disgusting.
Disgusting.
Smelly.
Smelly.
Smelly. Very good. Very good. Right. Remember, we have to say small, porque si decimos solamente mold, nos estamos refiriendo a otra cosa. Okay? Now, we have positive adjectives and negative adjectives. For example, this is my office. My office is big, it's huge for me. Right? But in the company, I have a small office. Entonces, ¿sí ven por qué decimos que son positivos y negativos? Okay? Cuando queremos describir algo que está bonito, bien hecho, right? We use positive adjectives and then we use negative adjectives, right? Now, let's use a dictionary to create some sentences. Or do you have a question about the vocabulary? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta del vocabulario? Porque son palabras nuevas, los adjetivos. ¿Alguna pregunta?
Confortable, no se le escucha bien cómo se pronuncia.
Comfortable.
¿Con qué es contable? Contable.
No, comfortable.
Deja de lado la F, la U y la R, se pasa de un solo octavo.
Comfortable.
No, siempre pronuncio la F.
Comfortable.
Muchas personas ustedes van a escuchar tal vez que alguien le diga comfortable. Eso está mal dicho, no lo digan, por favor. Eso es algo que alguien se inventó y está mal dicho. Y si les dicen se puede decir, no, no se puede decir comfortable. Ok, it's comfortable. The American person will say comfortable.
Okay?
Una persona americana. Nosotros queremos aprender inglés americano, vamos a decir comfortable.
Comfortable.
Okay? ¿Van a escuchar algún estudiante que va a decir, no, si se dice comfortable? No, that is incorrect. ¿Ok? That is incorrect. Okay. Ese es inglés inventado. Ok.
Ok, very good. Now,
do you have questions? Este, Franz.
Yes,
¿no? Narrow. Me he puesto nota, Franz.
Okay.
Narrow, it's for example some places. Okay, imagine when you're driving, your car, and sometimes there are streets that are huge, that they are wide. Okay, but sometimes there are streets that are very narrow and you cannot drive very well. Because the streets are very small, right? Narrow, son bien estrechas las calles, right? So when we say there is a narrow reception area, es una área de recepción que bien pequeña, bien estrecha, no está bien ubicada. That's narrow. Very good. Another question about the vocabulary.
There is a narrow
reception area.
¿Cómo dijo, Franz?
There is a narrow street, Soyapan.
Okay, thank you, Franz. Thank you very much.
Teacher.
Mm-hmm.
De los de las oraciones que están ahí, que son en plural, pueden también pasarse a singular o no.
Yes.
Porque yes. Me viene la duda de en la parte donde está la negative adjective, donde dice there are small office. No sé si esa también puede pasar a ser singular.
Yes, all of them. We can say there is a small office. There is a small office. Something that is very important to remember is that adjectives, they are not plural, right? Adjectives cannot be pluralized. Los adjetivos no se pueden hacer plurales. Los adjetivos son palabras que ya están hechas y no las vamos a hacer no las vamos a cambiar solo porque el nombre es singular o plural. Esa es muy buena pregunta, Nelson. Por ejemplo, en español decimos las camisas blancas, ¿verdad? Las camisas blancas. Y ponemos el adjetivo que es blanco, también lo ponemos en plural. En cambio, en inglés, the white shirt, right? The white shirts are going to be white shirts. El adjetivo no cambia su escritura. Entonces acá vamos a decir, there is a small office. Okay? Or we can say, there is a comfortable room. There is a nice place to rest. There are illuminated training rooms. Okay? Eso lo podemos cambiar sin ningún problema, Mr. Nelson. Okay?
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Okay, ahorita le voy a pasar la lista porque nos vamos a ir a la actividad de 10 a 11. Ya solo nos queda un minuto. Y seguimos mañana si tienen alguna pregunta acerca de esto. Ángela de Jesús Santa María Juárez.
Presente, teacher.
Thank you very much. Azalia Melanie Guardado Portillo. Claudia Yanet Ramos Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Present, teacher.
Eneida Yasmín Hernández Cruz. Francis Humberto Hernández Valle. Franco Damián Vázquez.
Present, teacher.
Juan Josué Hernández Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Leida Susana Sordo Cuadra.
Present.
Nancy María Serrano Checón.
Present.
Thank you. Nelson Brian Pereira Maravilla.
Present, teacher.
Norma Carolina Mata de Chévez. Pedrina Ileana Gómez Ortega.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Gabriel Barenga Ventura.
I'm here.
Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona.
Present.
Jennifer Abidey López Escoto.
Present, teacher.
José Alfonso Palma Mejía. Okay, so that's the attendance, guys. I see you tomorrow at 8 p.m. Have a beautiful night. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Good night.